So in the previous video, we have discussed the case 1 and case 2, and now case 3. Case 3 is the underdamped case. Underdamped case. That is k square or less than omega 0 square. Okay. If the damping is very low, that is k less than omega 0, if the damping is very low, this k less than omega 0, so the quantity is square root of k square minus omega 0 square, that is here k less than omega 0. So that means this will be a, inside this will be a, k square minus omega 0 will be a negative value. So what we can take, since k is less than omega 0, we are rearranging, we can write minus of omega 0 square minus k square. Okay, so this omega 0 square minus k square, denoting this term, square root of omega 0 square minus k square with omega. That is, you can write omega is equal to square root of omega 0 square minus k square, which is a real quantity. It's a real value. Real quantity. And I is equal to square root of minus 1. So this square root of minus 1 is equal to I. Okay. So now we can write the general equation, the general solution. The solution was x is equal to x of t is equal to A e raised to minus k plus square root of k square minus omega 0 square into t plus b into e raised to minus k minus square root of k square minus omega 0 square into t. Right. So for k square minus omega 0 square, we can give value plus or minus square root of minus 1 I square root of omega 0 square minus k square omega. Okay, so for square root of k square minus omega 0 square, we can substitute plus I omega, and minus square root of k square minus omega 0, we can write minus I omega. Okay, so we can substitute here e raised to minus k plus I omega into t plus b into e raised to minus k minus I omega into t. From here we can take e raised to minus kt common factor. E raised to minus kt we can take out. E raised to minus kt we can take it out. E raised to minus kt, e raised to minus kt, e raised to minus kt is there. Okay. So what will be inside? A e raised to I omega t plus B e raised to minus I omega t. Okay. So you can write it as e raised to minus kt A into, what is e raised to I omega t? That is cos omega t plus I sin omega t. E raised to I theta, cos theta plus I sin theta. Similarly, we can write e raised to I omega t is equal to cos omega t plus I sin omega t. This cos omega t plus I sin omega t. plus b into cos omega t minus I sin omega t. Okay. So here we can take a cos omega t and we can add b cos omega t. So cos omega t is common, you can take it common, and it would come as a plus b into cos omega t. So we can write a raised to minus kt a plus b into cos omega t plus I a plus b into minus I. So I into a minus b sin omega t and take it as a common factor. Okay. So e raised to minus kt a plus b into cos omega t plus I into a minus b sin omega t. Okay. So here since x is a real quantity, both a plus b and I into a minus b must be real. Okay, must be real values, because all other values are real values. So a plus b and I into a minus b must be a real quantity. So here x being a real quantity, both a plus b and I into a minus b must be real. Must be real values. Okay. So we can write a and b are complex quantity. Okay. Both a and b are, then only a plus b and I into a minus b must be real. Okay. Okay, so we can take two values to represent a plus b and a minus b. So if a plus b is equal to a zero sine phi and a I into a minus b is equal to a zero cos phi. Here a zero and phi are constants, its values depends on the initial condition, that is at the time t is equal to zero. Substitute a plus b is equal to a zero sin phi and I into a minus b is equal to a zero cos phi in this equation. So our equation become x of t is equal to what we'll get, e raised to minus kt cos omega t, so a zero sin phi cos omega t plus a zero cos phi sin omega t. Okay, so a zero can be taken out, so we can write a zero and e raised to minus kt cos omega t sin phi plus sin omega t cos phi. Okay, so this we can write cos omega t plus sin phi plus sin omega t plus cos phi. So what we can write? Yes, sin omega t cos phi plus cos omega t sin phi. It is equal to sin omega t plus phi. A zero e raised to minus kt sin omega t plus phi. Okay. So x of t is equal to a0 e raised to minus kt sin omega t plus phi. So this is the equation of a damped oscillatory simple harmonic motion with a0 e raised to minus kt as amplitude. So that is the amplitude decreases with respect to time. Okay, and with a new angular frequency omega. Omega is equal to omega 0 square plus square root of omega 0 square minus k square. So this omega will be less than omega 0. So omega 0 is equal to square root of c by m. Okay, so this is called the equation of damped oscillatory simple harmonic motion. The decreasing amplitude a0 e raised to minus kt with the new angular frequency omega is equal to omega 0 square minus k square, which is less than omega 0 is equal to c by m. Okay, so here we don't know what the value of a0 and phi, because a0 and phi came from here, a plus b and a minus b. So here a0 phi are there. So the value of a0 and phi depends on the initial condition. So we need to apply the initial condition to find a0 and phi. So initial condition means at x equal to a, that is maximum amplitude, the velocity will be equal to 0. So that in that case, we apply at a time t is equal to 0, we apply in x of t and as well as dx by dt, that is the velocity, that is also equal to 0. Okay, so we substitute the value of t is equal to 0 in x of t and dx by dt, and we find the value of a0 and cos phi. So that is we are going to write down in the next section. Okay, so I hope it is clear for you. Okay, and we'll continue the next section, determining the value of a0 and phi. Okay, to find the value of a0 and phi. Okay, so let the displacement x equal to a, it is a maximum displacement at time t is equal to 0. Okay, so that means we are taking the simple pendulum to the maximum displacement at a time t is equal to 0. From there, we start the oscillation. Okay, so t is equal to 0, maximum displacement. That is the amplitude, maximum amplitude. Okay, maximum displacement amplitude, x equal to a. So there, t will be at rest at a maximum amplitude when we start the oscillation. So dx by dt will be equal to 0. Okay, substitute this value, that is x equal to a and t is equal to 0, in our equation. So our equation was x of t is equal to a0 e raised to minus kt sine omega t plus phi. So that's our equation. So we are substituting the value t is equal to 0, x equal to a. So x of t become a, and a0, okay, e raised to minus kt, when t is equal to 0, e raised to 0, 1, sin omega t plus phi become sin phi. Okay, omega t become 0, but t is equal to 0, then become sin phi. Okay. And so we need to, then we need to take the dx by dt and substitute the condition. Okay, so that dx by dt, dx by dt at x equal to a is 0. Right, so we are going to substitute for dx by dt value. So dx by dt, what is dx by dt from here? So differentiating x of t equal to a 0 e rest minus kt sin omega t plus y with respect to time. Okay, so dx by dt is equal to so there are two time dependent functions here, e raised to minus kt and sin omega t plus y. Okay, so what we will do? E 0, minus k, differentiating e raised to minus kt, e raised to minus kt sin omega t plus y. Okay, plus second function a 0, what will get, omega will come out. Okay, omega e raised to minus kt, what is the differential of sin omega t? Cos omega t plus 1, cos omega t plus 5. Okay, so at x equal to a, this will become equal to 0. So we can equate and we can substitute what t is equal to 0. Okay, so what we will get? Okay, so substitute t is equal to 0 here. Okay, so at t is equal to 0, x equal to a, so dx by dt will be equal to 0. So we can, here we can say 0 is equal to minus a 0 k e raised to 0 1 sin omega t sin phi, because omega t become equal to 0 because t is equal to 0, plus a 0 omega e raised to minus 0, okay, e raised to 0 1 cos omega t plus phi, t becomes 0 then cos phi. Okay, so if we take it out, take it towards left side, this will become plus a 0 k, that is a 0 k sin phi is equal to a 0 omega cos phi. So from here we can take sin phi by cos phi, that is equal to tan phi, right? Tan phi is equal to, tan phi is equal to sin phi by cos phi. So we will go a 0 omega by a 0 k, that is equal to omega by k. Okay, so if we draw a triangle, and if this is phi, if we take tan phi, the opposite side will be omega bk, so this would be omega square plus k square, right? So that means if we have this, we can find the sin phi value. Sin phi will be equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, omega square plus k square. So we get the value of sin phi. Okay, substituting this value of sin phi here, so what we will get? We get the value of a 0. Okay, so that we are going to do here. A is equal to a 0 into omega by omega square plus k square. A is equal to a 0 sin phi, and we substitute the value, this become a 0 omega by square root of omega square plus k square.
So this is the value of A.
So here omega square, square root of omega square plus k square is there. So we know, what we know is omega square is equal to omega 0 square minus k square, right? So from here what we can, we substitute for that, what we will get? We will get A0 omega by omega 0 square minus k square plus k square. So minus k square plus k square will cancel out, we will get omega 0, right? So A become A0 omega by omega 0. What we need to find out? We need to find out A0. So from here A0 is equal to, in terms of maximum displacement, that is amplitude A, A0 is equal to A omega 0 by omega. That is the actual amplitude depends on the initial amplitude. That is at time t is equal to 0, x equal to A, but it depends on the ratio of omega 0 and omega. Okay. Okay. So, other way we can write is equal to A omega 0, what is omega square root of omega 0 square minus k square. Either way, we can represent it. Okay. So, so we have find A0 and phi. So, what we, the equation will come. This is our main equation. So x of t will be, x of t is equal to will be equal to A omega 0 by omega in terms of the amplitude, maximum displacement at t is equal to 0. So we can write e raised to minus kt sine omega t plus phi. Okay, or we can say A omega 0 by omega is equal to A0. A0 e raised to minus kt sine omega t plus phi. Okay, so this means the oscillator oscillate with respect to the equilibrium position, but the thing is its amplitude decreases gradually with respect to time. This A0 e raised to minus kt. Since sine theta value, maximum value is plus 1 and minimum value is minus 1. So this will oscillate between e raised to minus kt and minus e raised to minus kt. Okay, so we can draw the graph of based on this value, substitute value of time here and here, and we can draw the graphical representation how the oscillation amplitude gradually decreases exponentially. Okay, that we can we will draw the graph. Time x of t, maximum amplitude A. So it will go like this. Okay, A raised to minus kt. Yeah, this is minus A raised to minus kt. So the amplitude gradually decreases with respect to this e raised to minus kt factor. E raised to minus kt and minus e raised to minus kt. So the amplitude gradually decreases and it will, after a long time, it will dies away. Okay, so this is a graphical representation of underdamped case. Okay, yeah. Okay, in the plus two classes, you have studied about simple harmonic oscillation, and maybe you have did your experiment with the simple pendulum. So in simple pendulum case, we can see the oscillation dies away after some time once we start the oscillation. That is what is the real case of simple harmonic motion. So because of the friction by the air, the amplitude gradually decreases with respect to time, and it will dies away after some time, the oscillations. That is what is we have explained here. So the actual process happening here is we can represent with respect to this equation x of t is equal to e raised to minus kt sin omega t plus phi. And that is what is happening is represented here. So we can visualize how with the amplitude gradually decreases with respect to the factor e raised to minus kt. Okay. So I hope you understand the derivations and the explanation. So we can explain this condition or case 3 with respect to our plus 2 class simple pendulum experiment. Okay. So I hope it is clear for you. Okay. So please try to figure out from the beginning itself, so it will be very clear for you. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can directly contact me. Okay, then thank you for watching. Thank you very much.